Halo Infinite, developed by 343 Industries and published by Xbox Game Studios, is a spiritual gameplay reboot for the franchise following the much-maligned Halo 5 Guardians. The story continues on directly from the events of the previous games, including Halo Wars 2, so while 343 may say the game is a good starting point for fans and newcomers alike, it's really not, and you should watch the plot summaries of the story so far before starting your journey in Infinite. Infinite's story is squarely focused on providing fans with a conclusion to Master Chief and Cortana's story arc, while also introducing the Banished as the new primary threat. It does a decent enough job, giving us a deeper look into the humanity of Chief, while attempting to close the mess of a chapter that was Halo 5. However, it also continues a number of other plot threads from Halo 5 via audio logs that are scattered throughout the world, which are actually quite essential to fleshing out the larger story. If you're at all interested in the Halo lore, it's worth seeking these out, as they feel like teases for the kinds of stories we may be exploring in future expansions, seeing as how Infinite has already been described as the platform for Halo for the next 10 years. That said, the campaign that's currently available is extremely repetitive. The signs of development hell loomed large over the game's 7 missions. Attack a banished something, enter the same-looking Forerunner architecture, unlock some doors with some batteries, fight a boss, rinse, and repeat. While the story is good and essentially wipes the slate clean for what's next, the campaign missions feel almost tacked on, with many big story beats playing out over digital holograms, and no exciting scripted moments to speak of outside of the campaign opener. Most of the fun I had with Infinite comes from exploring its world, getting into battles, and taking down banished bases. The combat in Infinite is the best the series has ever been. Emergent gameplay moments take center stage in the overworld as you're able to attack objectives in any way you please using a variety of equipment on offer. The grapple hook especially allows for all sorts of experimentation and great moments like running out of ammo, using the hook to pull the nearest weapon to you, and continuing the fight. The Banished AI is fantastic, and even on normal difficulty the game poses a fun challenge. Unlike in other open world shooters, like say, Far Cry, the enemy is responsive to your actions and combat remains engaging at all times. It's Infinite's strongest area, and sets a great foundation for whatever comes next. However, the open world aspect of Infinite isn't without its flaws. It's attractive, but it doesn't exactly feel done. Stepping out and seeing the wide expanse of the ring for the first time is a fantastic moment, and being able to traverse the world in any way you please, whether it's on foot, in a vehicle, or attempting to swing around like Spider-Man, gives Infinite a level of freedom that the series hasn't seen before. That said, it's a far cry from what the game's 2018 tech trailer touted, and especially after recent reports, it really feels like there's some game missing. Much like the game's repetitive campaign, the open world is also lacking in visual variety. Every area feels mostly the same, and that's disappointing considering how good previous Halo games are at showing you a variety of different locales. The world in general feels too empty and underrealized. There are banished bases to take down, hidden audio logs, unique bosses with weapon variants to collect, and some propaganda towers with hilarious dialogue to topple. But aside from the story value of the audio logs, the only major incentive to do these things is to collect Spartan cores for a minimal upgrade system that is actually essential to beating some of the game's later bosses. Halo Infinite is also weirdly quiet. Every time I attack the banished base in the open world, I expected some heroic Halo music to accompany it, but instead, there is usually silence. There is a great soundtrack hidden in Infinite, with iconic pieces being used just enough to not overdo it on nostalgia, but it's a huge disappointment and missed opportunity that it shows up so rarely. While I've spent a lot of this review criticizing Halo Infinite, I did in fact enjoy my time with the game. It's a good game, and it has a good foundation, both in mechanics and story, but it lacks variety and feels less like a complete work and more like the start of something that could potentially end up being great through future content. It's an issue that seems to be plaguing a lot of my favorite franchises lately. Halo Infinite is available now on Xbox One, Xbox Series X and S, Xbox Game Pass, and Steam for $59.99.